good morning from Champions Park on Secret Island. This is Neverdie. And we are just over 10 minutes out from the MMOWC finals. This is a three-part event, 3 1.5-hour stages. This is truly epic to find the absolute best of MMO esports cyber athletes. We've got an incredible lineup of talent that have qualified through the opening rounds of the MMOWC and Champions League. Let's just take a look at who qualified and in what order yesterday. So through the semi-finals yesterday, Genestar Mercury, a longtime esports player from Entropia Universe, twice the runner-up in the MMOWC in 2008-2009. He got through the semi-finals with 689 points after 3 rounds. 1 hour rounds, that is. In second, very strategic in his play, was Lightstar. Lightstar was the winner of the 2015 Champions League season. He came in second yesterday, 523 points. Dematrix, new to the Champions League esports, it came in third with 518. Messi 91, a former Dot 2 champion, at one time the captain of the possibly the best Dot 2 team in the world, came in fourth. In fifth place, legendary Entropia Uber Yoda, accompanied by Lindsay. In sixth, Lindsay and Yoda, known for working together. Lindsay has a, from what I understand, I haven't had the pleasure, a top-of-the-line cyber cafe land center in Sweden. So Lindsay came in sixth place yesterday with 432. We had a couple of surprises. In seventh, Strong Soul. Strong Soul was very late getting started with the Champions League season, the 2015 Champions League season, but managed to pre-qualify for the semi-finals by cracking the top 10 after only 8 appearances. Then we have two of our most consistent Rocktropia players, Lunchbox and Taco. Champions League veterans already, even after one season. Two of the great characters from the Champions League came in 8th and 9th with 335 and 296. And finally, in 10th place, after a bit of a rough semi-final, Blondie, who raced up the charts in the Champions League, up the leaderboard, to finish in 4th. Or was it 3rd? Let me just double check. Finishing 4th last season after only 16 rounds played. So Blondie, we haven't seen the best of him yet in the MMOWC. It's going to be very exciting today. So this is truly an epic afternoon. 3 90-minute rounds. Two of them most loot, so that means the big guns definitely have an advantage today. Can some of the underdogs, the outsiders, find a way to use bonus points strategy to overcome any potential disadvantages? That is the big question. I'm going to try to get an insight into the weapons that everybody's using today so we can kind of get a sense of who's got what to work with. Although there are so many factors besides just the guns, you know, the choice of mob, the armor, the speed of the FAP, the stims, all of these things are factors. What's fantastic is that we've got absolutely some of the best, if not the best esports, the top, how about that, the top esports players in Entropia Universe here today. And they're going to go head to head, and they all want to win, which is so exciting. So nobody's, everybody's in it to win it. And we're going to see what they're thinking as we start to see the exploding globals. What strategy they think is going to work. Looking at yesterday, kind of interesting. In the first round, actually, yesterday's first round was dominated by Dematrix. Dematrix was all over the Death Drakes, and he was really on fire. Managed a 240 point round. He landed in the top spot with a 749 paired Hoff on a Death Drake, and since it was the highest single loot event, that grabbed him 100 points. Not far behind was Messi 91. Messi was also on the Death Drakes, threw in a storm. So the Death Drakes really were putting out. Lightstar, it was a little bit more diverse in his strategy. Focused a little bit more on the Great White Sharks, which are typically a bit more challenging. And Star and Yoda, who ended up midfield, Yoda was cranking on the Snowdrakes, which were on fire because Strong Soul had a great run on them too, while Star was on the Stormdrakes. All of these different mobs actually were really, you know, probably almost even. In round two, however, Star pulled right ahead. He had a 248 point round, and he just stuck to the Stormdrakes. Yoda was on the Stormdrakes. So Star and Yoda were on the Stormdrakes. Yoda didn't have quite as much love back from them, and he ended up with only 158 point round. Lindsay changed it up. So Lindsay was a lot less predictable. Lightstar had a freaking disastrous round with a single Stormdrake. Now, almost, I don't think I've ever seen around like that for Lightstar. So he actually, I mean, to finish, oh my god, you know, I've not even thought about this. Lightstar had a 42 point round in round two yesterday, okay, versus, let's say, Jenna Star Mercury, who had a 248 point round. So 200 points difference. Lightstar finished second in the semi-finals overall with 523, even with a completely disastrous round. So I would say that suggests that Lightstar is qualifying for the finals a lot closer to Jenna Star Mercury than the current results reflect. So Lightstar, Jenna Star Mercury, two completely different strategies. Dematrix, we'll see if he sticks to the Death Drakes today. Messi 91, so he was on the Death Drakes a lot in the first round, moved to the Snowdrakes in the second, and was back on the Death Drakes and the Snowdrakes in round three. So basically, he's sticking to a pretty simple formula, but it didn't work out too badly, although it wasn't good enough. So let's see if he changes things up today. Yoda and Lindsay, I don't know. I don't know if they were really trying that hard. I think they're just qualifying for the final, and they're going to surprise everybody with their strategies. And of course, Strong Soul, Lunchbox, Strong Soul, Blondie all had to work extremely hard. Blondie had a very good first round, in fact. He changed it up. He was on a bunch of different mobs. finished with 194. He didn't score a lot of globals, but he had a diversity in the mobs that he was hunting. Round two yesterday, Blondie struck out, actually as bad as, worse than Lightstar. He got a single Death Drake and didn't even crack the top 10. So that was a fiasco. But he was back in round three with... Actually, round three wasn't really that good for Blondie either. He just got a Pirate Skeleton and a Death Drake in round three. So Blondie, that's why Blondie just squeezed through. He had two really off rounds. I don't know what he was hunting, but perhaps because he was trying for the diversity in the mobs and, you know, just wasn't, it wasn't working out. So anyway, we're going to look, we're starting fresh. And we'll be taking some wagers, wagering your wisdom. That's all you gotta put up as a stake. On the skeezer windows, we've got three skeezer windows per round. I'm sorry that Skeezer isn't here to see this. But you know what? At least he is with us in spirit. So, if the players want to shout out their Twitch streams, that'll be very helpful. That way we can get you set up. We've got some incredible prizes up for grabs today. We got a unlimited level 80 King Kong Tommy Gun, two level 80 unlimited King Kong Snub Nose. We got a level 60 unlimited Tommy Gun. We've got an Oculus Rift and HTC Vive. Obviously, everybody qualified picks up a MMOWC 2015 harness. So yeah, and you know, I'm sure that the title itself is a prize that a lot of people in this event value. To be the world champ, this is a world championship. I mean, really and truly, although, you know, we don't have, let's say, the kind of, no MMO championship that takes place in the world today is really featuring players from every MMO, because they're very specific typically to the game or the game that they're taking place in. I mean, I like to think that we have a slightly broader genre, a sort of broader spectrum here. I mean, I really think that we could have and support players from other MMOs, but of course they've got to build up their avatars. But this, at the end of the day, the bottom line is we have players from every country in the world. We've got champion.2 player, we've got, you know, we've got MMOWC runner-up 2 years in a row, Genestar Mercury. We've got Lindsay, who's, you know, obviously a true, you know, hardcore lover of esports. You know, he's got a whole culture in Sweden that he's you know, developing around esports. So, you know, and then we've got really just the most fantastic characters, Taco Tuesday. I mean, so dedicated, such passionate Entropia players, avatars. And there goes the Matrix, because we are underway. There we go. There's the first global of the MMOWC final, and it is a Hoff for the Matrix. The Matrix gets out of the gate with a Death Drake worth 583 ped. That's a 12 point bonus for the Matrix. So just getting some of the streams in. Messi 91 is Bird 83. Tap these into the MMOWC stream so you can see people in action and follow the commentary. So, okay, most loot event this is, and the Matrix is in the lead from the outset with a fantastic 583 ped Death Drake off Lindsay. Right behind. He's on the Death Drakes too. So Death Drake's popular, seems. So the Matrix ahead of Lindsay, Jenna Star Mercury in third, Strong Soul sitting there in Messi 91 moves into fourth, and the Matrix gets another one. That's two for the Matrix. Death Drakes on fire right away. So the Matrix, Lindsay in second, Jenna Star Mercury, Messi 91, Strong Stole. There goes Lightstar getting into it early with a Storm Drake. Lightstar certainly made a big impact on Champions League with those Storm Drakes early in the season. Not everybody not everybody was able to repeat the success that he had with them though. So Demetrix leads, Lightstar now moves up into second ahead of Jenna Star Mercury. Lindsay drops back to fourth ahead of Strong Soul. 91 in sixth, Yoda seventh. Lunchbox now in seventh, Yoda drops back to eighth. Tarko is in ninth and Blondie's in tenth. There's the top 10. So, you know, looking at yesterday's scores, no telling who was really, you know, going all out and who was trying to qualify. But Jenna Star Mercury and Lightstar appear to be the favorites. This day, I almost hate to say it, but they're the ones to beat. The Matrix, it's going to be so interesting, but you got to have your favorites. So let's say Jenna Star Mercury and Lightstar look like the ones to beat, and everybody else is right there. We'll see after round how things shape up, but nobody can afford to throw away a round. Every round is just priceless. If you have a good first round, that can carry you through round two if it's rough, you know, especially if you can get a huge advantage. So the Matrix now, and the Matrix is absolutely, I don't even know that much about the Matrix. he's a dark horse as far as I'm concerned, because he's certainly performing really well. He's qualified in third place for the final. He worked his way through the MMOWC. He wasn't part of the Champions League. Let's actually go through the results. So the Matrix qualified in third in event 6 and in event 7 and in event 8 of the opening round. There goes the Matrix again with a 142 ped Death Drake. So there we go. The Matrix is already on the hat trick. Round 2, he came in third in event 3. That was enough. And there's Tarko with a great white. So Tarko getting into it, not waiting too long this time, which is good for him, with a nice 239 ped Great White Shark. Good start for Tarko, followed right away by Lindsay with a 136 Death Drake. So Lindsay 2 on the Death Drakes. Strong Soul now with a 16 bonus point Snowdrake worth 101 ped. So let's take a look where the leaderboard is. The Matrix is leading ahead of Tarko. Lindsay in third. Messi 91. Strong Soul. Lightstar in sixth. Jenna Star Mercury in seventh. Lunchbox in eighth. And Yoda 9th, Blondie 10th. There is Lunchbox getting into it. Lunchbox with a Snowdrake as well. So far, just Star, Yoda, Messi 91, and Blondie to score. We
are
just 6 or 7 minutes into it. So going back to Dematrix, tracking him through the MMOWC, finished third in event three in round two. In the round three, came in second in event two. And there's Dematrix again. I've got to stop talking about him because it appears to help him with these globals. So Dematrix again, a 114 ped Death Drake. He continues to lead. So Dematrix came in second behind Kazunori in event two of round three. That was all he needed to qualify for the quarterfinals. In the quarterfinals, he was in event two with Lindsay and Yoda, who finished ahead of him. Dematrix qualified in third place. So all the way to the semifinals, actually, Dematrix was in third again. So Dematrix has actually a little bit of an affinity with being third. So let's hope that he doesn't get stuck there. Dematrix, very consistent and a dark horse. No idea what to expect from him, except for now he's got 48 bonus points and he's leading the way. So Dematrix, Lindsay in second, Taco in third. Obviously, you know, turning over the loot. Taco's got some firepower to be in third place right now, though he did hit that nice 229 ped Great White Shark. Actually, 239. So still under 10 minutes. There's Jenna Star Mercury. Makes a statement with his first one. That's a 462 ped Storm Drake. So Jenna Star Mercury back on the Storm Drakes. 462 ped. That was almost worth only getting one bonus to land right in second on the leaderboard. So Jenna now moves into second place with that 462. Messi now climbed up to third ahead of Lindsay. Messi 91 ahead of Lindsay in fourth. Taco back in fifth now. Strong Soul, Light Star, Lunchbox, and Yoda. First time's home. How many streams we got going on right now? So from what I understand, Jenna Star Mercury has the Terminator. Terminator, reputed to be the most powerful weapon in the universe, but I believe there's a few that give it a run for its money. I'm not sure if they're tiered up far enough yet. Another stream here is Lunchbox. So let's hear a little bit about the countries that are being represented in the MMOWC. Hopefully the players will help me because I'm not on top of everything. Obviously we've got Jenna Star Mercury from the USA, Light Star from Sweden, Dematrix. Where's Dematrix from? And what about Messi 91? I know Lindsay's in Sweden. What about Yoda? Strong Soul, Lunchbox, and Taco, both USA. And I might need a little bit of help from where Blondie originates from. I always think that he originates from the good, the bad, and the ugly. It's all always brings to mind Eli Wallach's character. And he's always teasing Clint Eastwood. Hey, Blondie! So that's Blondie for me. So, things gone quiet right now. 12 minutes in. There's Messi 91 with the first for him. Messi 91 gets a Death Drake. 110 paired. Blondie's from Germany. From what I hear, someone is from Kazakhstan. Gainham, Messi 91 again with another Death Drake. Back to back Death Drakes. That's 24 bonus points total for Messi. Having a little bit of trouble with Lunchbox's live stream. Not sure if that was the Lunchbox LB. Did I miss something? Messi 91 from Romania. So we got Romania. To write this down. There's Taco. Taco with a Death Drake this time. So Taco working on the 20 point hat tricks. The Matrix just working on quantity. Death Drake certainly the mob of choice right now, but it's so early. Oh, Lunchbox is Lunchbox Pale Horse. Oh, you're seeing it. And there's another one for Yoda. Yoda Storm. That was the first for Yoda. That's 12. So now just Blondie looking to get into it. So let's take a look at the leaderboard. The Matrix. We're just getting started here. Just getting warmed up. Already seeing the Matrix really cranking like crazy. Four Death Drakes. He's on top of the leaderboard with Jenna Star Mercury right there behind him. Messi 91 in third. So dot two champ from Romania. Lindsay in fourth. Taco. Taco is such a great cat. Taco, where are you from, Taco, exactly? So Taco from the USA, Strong Soul. Yoda and Lightstar. Bondi in the rear. There's Lindsay with another Death Drake. That's a hat trick now for Lindsay. Jennifer Mercury with another Storm. So the goal of this event is to, you know, actually have an event where those people that are invested in their avatars, committed to esports, can battle it out for a title, a world championship title. There's Messi 91 again with a Death Drake. That's a hat trick. He got off to a late start, but now he's flying. So the Death Drakes. Right now, the Death Drakes have dropped 10. Storm Drake's trailing with four. couple of snow drakes. Actually, 11 on the death drakes. But what we don't want to see with the MMOWC is anybody able to tip the scales too far for the wrong reasons. We want to keep it extremely competitive. So we're going to, as each season of the Champions League takes place, we will be introducing new bonus opportunities to keep it competitive and to level the playing field as much as possible without taking away the basics that enable the most dedicated players to excel. But we were also going to explore other skill factors that are not necessarily ideally suited for this platform when it comes to hunting, but we look at new ways to explore, you know, the gamer, the traditional gamer skills, the reflexes, the dexterity, so timing. So look out for that in the summer games, and that's something you can anticipate for next year's MMOWC. So we've got three skeezer windows in these 90-minute rounds, one at the end of the first 30 minutes, and then at the end of the first hour, and then the last 5 minutes of the event. So we'll start taking bets on the skeezer window. If you get the if you pick who gets the first one, that's worth 100 Robux. Second is 50, third is 25. It's a first-come, first-served basis, so this is a Twitch chat event only, so you have to let us know in the Twitch stream who you're backing for the skeezer window. We are closing in. We're just 5-6 minutes out of the first skeezer window. That's where players can get double and triple points on the mobs. Some of them are huge bonus opportunities, and that's why the skeezer window is named for Skeezer. Skeezer's pulled out some just ridiculous combos in these windows during the course of the Champions League. There goes Dematrix again with another Death Drake. That's number 5. That's 60 bonus points total for Dematrix. Anybody want to care to tell me where Dematrix is from? Star USA, Lightstar from Sweden, Lindsay from Sweden. Just Strong Soul, Dematrix, and Yoda. I just need confirmation where they're from. So yeah, okay, so back to the, you know, authenticity of this event, right? I mean, this is a massive multiplayer online platform. It's the most challenging because it takes real money that you have to invest in your avatar to skill up. I mean, it takes huge commitment and confidence to have tens of thousands of dollars invested in your avatar and in your equipment, and all of these players do, you know. So I mean, to have this kind of investment, confidence in a platform, you know, even if they don't love it, but these are really the forefront of massive multiplayer gaming, because, you know, You gotta have a true confidence and understanding of the genre to be doing this. In addition, these are people that have been competing for years, and in order to compete, they have to know the numbers like the back of their hand. They have to track down the best equipment, the best everything. Then they have to put in the hours in order to, you know, really develop a strategy to be on top of their game. So I really would argue that these are the best MMO players in the world. And, you know, I mean, okay, sure, there may be some absolutely fabulous MMO players out there, but, you know, where are they competing? And actually, I heard very recently that, and this was my suspicion, that the churn rate on esports players on most platforms is very high, which means that esport players on a lot of other platforms do not necessarily stick around for very long. So very hard to develop a culture around top players because they're not there for long. And because, you know, so what I love about this is that we've got longevity right here in these players, which makes it very interesting as things unfold. We are 3 minutes outside of the skeezer window. Things have been a little bit quiet since Dematrix got his last death drake. Currently, Dematrix leads, Genestar Mercury in second, Messi 91 in third, Lindsay fourth, Taco doing well, holding fifth ahead of Yoda, Strong Soul in sixth, Lightstar in eighth right now. Right now, Lightstar back into 7th, Strong Soul drops to 8th, Lunchbox in 9th, and Blondie in 10th. So Dematrix, actually relatively new to Entropia Universe, only 2.5 years he's been playing. Look, he's on top of the leaderboard in the first round of the grand final of the Massive Multiplayer Online World Championships. A USA player, only 2.5 years. Now let's actually, how long has Messi been playing? This is another important question, because, you know, this gives us an indication of what it takes. How long does it take to be able to compete in a world championship? Now that's, you know, I mean, that's actually quite interesting. I don't think that's unreasonable amount of time to ask of people who would want to compete in this to, you know, to spend, you know, developing their avatars and learning the ropes, building their skills, acquiring the necessary equipment. I mean, in what sport do you just walk right in and get to compete in a world championship final? So Dematrix, great example of somebody who's obviously got a vision and a determination to be a top player. And there goes Messi 91 with a death rate. Messi 91, who I believe is also fairly new scene. That's number 4 for Messi 91. He's in third place right now. So Messi 91, his team was the TEG, the Gods, and they won their first Dot 2 tournament in 2004. Messi went by the name Bird. So there goes Lindsay with another Snowdrake. Well, that's actually Lindsay's first Snowdrake. So that's number 4 for Lindsay. Just a 51 ped Snowdrake, and that was in the skeezer window. We are in the skeezer window, and Lindsay gets a double Snowdrake. That's worth 32 bonus points. Oh my god, there's Messi with a giant Deathdrake worth 655. That's a double death drake for Messi. Worth 655 pen. That's enough to put Messi. That's a Hoff. Messi is now on top of the leaderboard. So Messi now pulls ahead of Demetrix. Messi from Romania now on top of the leaderboard. Looking at the betting, Spart nabbed Messi. That was for 50 Robux. And looks like nobody had Strong Soul. So right now, Spart. Lindsay. Spart, $50. And there's another one for Lindsay. Lindsay gets his third. No, wait. I apologize. Yeah, he did. He got another one. Lindsay, another Snowdrake. That's 16. So two Skeezer window bonuses so far for Lindsay. 32 each for those. So Lindsay really taking advantage of the Skeezer window. We've got 2 minutes remaining. Two for Lindsay, one for Messi 91, but he nabbed that Hoff. Lindsay back and forth. So Lindsay got quite an up. There's Jenna Star Mercury in the Skeezer with a nice storm drake. That's the hat trick for Jenna Star. 24 bonus points. So right now, Star looking at 48 bonus points. Light Star still slow out the gate, only 12. Lindsay's got three Death Drakes worth 36. Then he's got two Snow Drakes during the Light Star times it to perfection in the Skeezer window. A minute remaining. He got a Great White Shark worth 24. So I'm sure that's a relief. So Great White Shark worth double for Light Star. That puts him at 36 bonus points. Light Star, though, way back in the field as far as actually not even on the leaderboard when it comes. Oh, no, he is. He's in fifth overall. That's worth 60 points. So he's positioned in the middle of the pack. So Lindsay with those three Death Drakes worth 36 and 64. So he's at 102 bonus points right now. 15 seconds remaining of the Skeezer window. 15 seconds remaining. 10. Oh, Messi 91 with another Death Drake right in the last seconds. 5 seconds remaining. That's it. Skeezer window is closed. And Messi landed two. So another Death Drake for Messi. That was a great Skeezer window for Messi. There's Demetrix a little bit too late with the Snowdrake. So we're 30 minutes in and we've seen quite a lot of action. Just Blondie waiting to really get into it. Blondie at the back of the field. That's not surprising given that no globals at all. Demetrix again. That's another 64 ped Snowdrake. That's worth 16 bonus points. And Light Star with another Great White Shark. Two Great Whites for Light Star. Blondie working hard to get into it. Something's got to give, Blondie. Quite often seeing Blondie come and get going late. But anyway, unlike yesterday, these yesterday were 60 minute rounds. These are 90 minute rounds. This is, you know, this is a true test of stamina, just 30 minutes in between each round. You know, the 90 minute round's critical because it reflects the Champions League season, and it really gives a chance to see some consistency emerge within the round itself. The 30 minute round's obviously very quick. Whoever gets out the gate fastest is going to win. 60 minute rounds, you know, actually we saw some people, you know, just get pulled so far ahead. But the third 30 minutes in the 90 minute rounds gives a chance for people to catch up, you know. Of course, if somebody goes crazy, I mean, it's like any race, right? How often does somebody pull out ahead and stay ahead for the entire race? Whereas on, you know, somebody will pull out ahead and then other people will just rein them back in gradually. So the 90 minutes, it's like, you know, again, as well, we got the comparisons with soccer. I mean, it works out. So that's our classic time frame where, you know, in a single round, everybody gets a real chance to go at it. So we've got three 90-minute rounds today. Because we got to see that consistency over the course of three events to determine who's the champion. So Messi, 91, ahead of Jenna Star-Mercury in second. The Matrix. Oh, Jenna Star actually moved up to second to ahead of Demetrix. So Jenna Star, just three Storm Drakes. He got one pretty big one though. I didn't record the number, but a pretty good Hoff. There's Taco again, Snowdrake. And that is the hat trick for Taco. Taco, one of our most passionate and emotional players. Oh, there's Lightstar with another great white shark. That's a hat trick and a nice one too. 265 ped. That moves Lightstar up into fourth. Taco's in sixth. Yeah, Taco, very dedicated, extremely passionate, and he's gonna work very hard. We can see he is already working hard for his score here today. So Messi, 91, Jenna Star-Mercury, Demetrix, Lightstar, Lindsay, Yoda, Taco drops back to 7th now, Lunchbox in 8th, Strong Soul and Blondie. So Yoda only got one Stormdrake right now, Lunchbox with one Snowdrake, Strong Soul with a Snowdrake, Blondie still not got any bonus points, but Taco with a nice hat trick. That's a 20-point hat trick for Taco. So Taco looking pretty good. He's positioned. He could use a Hoff on his next one. So Taco looking for a Hoff to propel him further up the leaderboard. But he's working hard. Messi, 91. Six Death Drakes, including two Skeezer Window bonuses. The Matrix with five Death Drakes and two Snow Drakes. So he's moving around. Lindsay, Patrick on the deaths, two Snow Drakes, both within the Skeezer Window. Lightstar, three Great White Sharks and a Storm Drake. And Star, just three Storm Drakes, but Star closing in on the top of the field. So unlike yesterday, the Storm Drakes so far not putting out as much. You know, what's interesting here is that, again, very easy to say, ah, well, those mobs and this, that, but actually it's changes. I'm not going to use the word dynamic, but you know, it's unpredictable what's gonna give at any time. And there goes Taco. He gets a Vulcan Drake this time, and it's a little bit bigger, not quite a Hoff, I don't think. Let me just check the today's Hoff Hall of Fame. Nope. 503 paired is the lowest Hoth. But Tarko gets a nice Vulcan Drake there. And that is enough to trade places again with Yoda. So Tarko now moves up to 6 with that one. That's a 7-point bonus for that.
Damn, son.
So I don't have the, I don't see the bonus leaderboard in front of me, but just to double check, we got Strong Soul with a 16 points for a Snowdrake. We've got Tarko with 49 bonus points, excluding the hat tricks, of course. Lunchbox with a 16-point Snowdrake. Messi 91 with 72 bonus points, excluding hat tricks. Oh, no, two doubles. So 72, 96. 96 bonus points for Messi 91 on the Death Drakes. And 92 bonus points for Dematrix. Yoda's got 12 for the Storm Drake. And Lindsay's got 100 bonus points with two Snowdrakes, each worth 32, so that's 64, and then three Death Drakes worth 36. So Lindsay, nice combo he's put together. 100 bonus points right there, excluding hat tricks again. Great Star. It's got three Great White Sharks, including one Skeezer. So 28, 56, 68 bonus points for Light Star. And Jenna Star Mercury's got three Storm Drakes, but one of them was a Skeezer, so that's 48 for Jenna Star Mercury. So that's where things are standing as far as the bonus points are concerned. The leaderboard, Messi 91, looking at a nice 100 points. She can hold on to first. Jenna Star Mercury in second with 90. Matrix in third, Lindsay fourth, Lightstar fifth, Tarko in sixth, Yoda seventh, Lunchbox, Strong Soul, and Blondie. So we are 40 minutes into this round. We've got another Skeezer window coming up pretty soon. So we can start. You can start wagering in the Twitch chat stream. Yes, my coffee for a second. Gotta keep my energy up. But I don't know. It doesn't really. Oh, there's another one for Tarko. Pirate Skeleton this time. 16-point Pirate Skeleton for Tarko. That's number 4. That's number 5, in fact. Yoda with a Storm Drake worth 12. That's number 2 for Yoda. So I'm very impressed right now with Tarko. Still in 6, but really nice combo of mobs. It's really, you know, again, this, the fact that this is quite a marathon final is really very interesting, because it gives us a real chance to, you know, see how people can hold it together over 3 of these epic rounds. Lightstar with a Snowdrake. That's 50. That's number 5 for Lightstar. That's worth 16. I think we should also. I think after this next Skeezer window, I think we should after round one, let's see what people who people are backing for the event as a whole. So we'll take some. I'll figure out some reward system for Rockbox rewards for predicting the outcome of this event. We'll wait till this round is done. That way you can all kind of, you know, decide Oh, there goes Strong Soul. Lightstar gets us another Snowdrake, and Strong Soul finally breaks his duck with a 91 ped Snowdrake as well. So, that's the second for Strong Soul. I'm sorry, it's Blondie that we're waiting for. But Lightstar gets another one too. So no, Strong Soul, that's his second. That's worth 32 now. Still waiting for Blondie. He's really suffering back in 10th place, wondering. I mean, you gotta wonder what the hell is going on when it takes you this long to get into the game. Lunchbox probably feeling the same way. But you know what? Don't despair, either of you, because it's only 45 minutes in. You're not even halfway through round one of three in the MMOWC finals, which is, you got half of this event to suddenly be the top scorer, okay, and let somebody else barely score. So just keep your noses to the grindstone and trust your instincts, and things are going to unfold. Again, you know, I mean, oh, there's Dematrix with a Snowdrake. Nice 224 ped Snowdrake for Dematrix, and Dematrix now moves ahead of Genistar Mercury. It's another Snowdrake for Dematrix. What's you know, it's quite interesting, certainly with Dematrix being a fairly new player, and I believe Messi91 is fairly new. What is it? Can somebody find out for me how long Messi91 has been playing? I understand completely if the hunters themselves do not want to take their fingers off the trigger. That is if their fingers are on the trigger. So, to looking at the wagering for the next skeezer window, the Unicate is on Lightstar, Spart for Taco, Bubblicious for Genistar Mercury, Cotton Magic for Lunchbox. And there's Lunchbox right on cue with a nice 178 ped Stormdrake. It's number two. We're not quite halfway. Lunchbox already two-thirds of the way to a nice hat trick. Lunchbox moves into eighth with that one. That's worth 30 points in itself. He's ahead of Strong Soul and Blondie. So Messi, approximately 3 years. So, you know, just this little snapshot of this moment. We're halfway through round one of the MOWC. We got Genistar Mercury, whose avatar is almost as old as Never Die. born sometime in 2002, so that's a 14-year avatar, and he's in third place behind a 2.5-year-old and a 3-year-old, right? So, obviously, it's early days yet, but right at this moment, if the event was over right now, Genistar Mercury would be trailing the noobs. And there's Yoda with a hat trick now on the Stormdrakes. I'm sure Messi91 and Matrix think it's funny to be called noobs. But, you know, obviously relative to Genistar Mercury, you guys are noobs. But it's great.
Disappointed, but there are no vampires. There never were vampires.
So Lightstar, certainly been around for longer than that. You know, please call out your time, your years in, if possible. or somebody, let us know in the Twitch stream. Lightstar, I know, is 14. Still don't know where Strong Soul is from. Or Yoda. Confirmation for Strong Soul and Yoda for their nationality. Tarko, 6.5 years. There's Genistar Mercury. Ooh, God, I must have betted him because he freaking well just landed a nice 892 ped Stormdrake. 892 ped hop on the Stormdrakes for Genistar Mercury to take the spot. He did not like having a 2.5 and a 3 year old ahead of him. And his Strong Soul right behind with a 75 ped Snowdrake. That's a hat trick on the snows for Strong Soul. Blondie, 9 years with a 4 year break in there, but 9 years nevertheless. Obviously, that's 4 years of no skill development. So it's sort of 5 years of playing. But, you know, nevertheless, 9 years with his avatar. As I was driving to the studio this morning, for some reason, I was thinking about this thing, you know, this attachment to avatars, advocating for avatar rights and... You know, of course, people have no idea what that means, right? you know, I think we must share this affinity that we have with our avatars and the people, particularly in this universe. We are invested not just in our skills but also in our identity, you know, I think that this is something that we're way ahead of the curve. And there's Lindsay with another Snowdrake. It's the first one for Lindsay for a while. But yeah, like, you know, really, if the world keeps going in the direction that it's going and people are more immersed in virtual reality and, you know, global, you know, cryptocurrencies and their avatars, effectively, they're gonna suddenly start to feel the way that we feel, right? So avatar rights are important. I mean, avatar rights are critical when you have a lot invested in them, right? I mean, we don't want people messing with our avatars, just like we don't want people messing with us in reality. So, you know, it's funny because championing that idea in a world that just hasn't yet even got their head around it is, you know, certainly made me feel like a bit of a loony. But I just gotta assume that everybody in this world, you know, shares the same sentiment to some extent, right? You know, Genistar Mercury wants to be Genistar Mercury. Messi 91 wants to stay Messi 91. Right? Every global, every Hoff, every discovery, every event done, every friend made, it all... It's all something that then becomes associated with the specific avatar that is yours. There's Genistar Mercury with a Stormdrake. That's number 5 for Star. We're closing in on that second skeezer window. Billie Jean backing Never Die. Do I get to hunt for 5 minutes? I dare not hunt at all because I tend to get lucky and Hoff. and then I screw up the leaderboard. So Mike, Game Over Rocky Man is on Messi 91. Game Over PTP is on Yoda. Microdot is on The Matrix. K-Max on Lindsay. And Sandal on Blondie. We have 3 minutes remaining. Yeah, I mean, an avatar, you know, if you take it into a different context, it's like, you know, Snoop Dogg, right? That's his avatar. It's his alter ego. I mean, you know, it's his intellectual property, right? Eminem, right? So many entertainers, particularly, you know, create alter egos as their vehicle. Obviously in traditional sports, people tend to just be themselves, and you know, therefore their rights are protected. In fact, in the real world, we got intellectual property rights that protect identities like, you know, a name, an artist name like Snoop Dogg or The Rock. You know, the world WWE, got that right, is they still own the name The Rock. That's why he, Dwayne Johnson, really had to transition into his own name when he started making movies. But there goes The Matrix and Strong Soul back to back. Snowdrakes for The Matrix and Strong Soul. So, so when you look at it in that context, avatar rights are critical. There's Lightstar with a Death Drake. You know, I see them as our intellectual property. Obviously, we want security because we have... You know, they're accounts. They're we're heavily invested in them. There's Yoda with a Snowdrake. It's number four for Yoda, and we are 1 minute away from the skeezer window. 40 seconds. Fifteen seconds. Hold back, boys. 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's it. It's skeezer time. So Genistar Mercury is on top of the leaderboard, ahead of Messi 91, The Matrix in third, Lightstar in fourth, Yoda fifth now, ahead of Taco, Yoda's in sixth, Taco's in seventh, Strong Stole, Lunchbox and Blondie. Only Blondie yet to get out of the gate. Rooting for him right now in the skeezer window. Time to do some real damage. So Lindsay all the way back in sixth now. So really widespread here on the bonus points as we are about to enter the final 30 minutes, the final stretch. Plus bonus points just on the individual mobs so far for The Matrix. The Matrix right now in third place. Doesn't want to lose too many places, really, because it starts to add up, you know, the difference between first and fourth. 100 100 versus 70. But Demetrix in third, that's worth 80 points on top of his 120. So Demetrix are looking like a 200 point round potentially, and we're just almost at the 1 hour mark. We got 3 minutes left of the skeezer window. Thus far, nobody went through. The last one, though, we had six globals in the skeezer window. Star, light star, two for Lizzie, two for Messi 91. Here we are already 2 minutes, over 2 minutes into it. No sign of anything. Blondie, come on, Blondie. Get into it. We don't want any stragglers in this event. Blondie, come on, you can do it. So Blondie, lunchbox only two so far as well. And not because those mobs haven't globaled, that's for sure. Strong Souls had four on the Snowdrakes. Lindsay gets the first one, and that is good news for K-Max. 100 Rock Bucks for K-Max. So Lindsay, followed by Strong Soul with another 189 ped Snowdrake. So Snow worth 32 for Strong Soul, and Lindsay gets a Storm. That's worth 24. And who backed Strong Soul? Doc Gray gets 50 Rock Bucks for that. And we have 1.5 minutes remaining, so just Lindsay and Strong Soul thus far. Lindsay gets another Storm Drake. He's really good at the geezer windows. So that's worth 24 more for Lindsay. That's number three. And that means actually that K-Max gets another 25 Rock Bucks. So that's it. ...45 seconds remaining of the skeezer window. Blondie, all eyes on you. 30 seconds remaining. Show Blondie some love. Time to get onto the... get into the action, grab some points. 20 seconds. 15 seconds remaining. 10. 8. 7. 5. 4. 3. 2. 1. That's it. Not much excitement in that skeezer window. Just Strong Soul. Lindsay got two. So, Genistar Mercury continues to lead. He's looking at 100 points for that. Messi, 90. Demetrix, 80. Lindsay, 70. Lightstar, 60. There's Genistar Mercury with another Storm Drake with 212. Genistar Mercury may be almost unassailable in the lead right now with the most loot. Lindsay in fourth. Climb back up now. Lightstar 5th, Yoda 6th, Strong Soul in 7th now, Tarko in 8th, Lunchbox and Blondie. Let's take a look. Let's see if we can get a handle on the bonus points right now. But let's focus on the leaders and see what things look like. So Genistar Mercury has got 6 storms plus a double. So let's call that 7 just for the purpose of bonus points. So 84 bonus points plus obviously hat tricks and what have you, but 84 plus the top spot. So he's looking at 184 right now for Star. Light Star Oh, there's another one for Jenna Star Mercury. Just trying to screw my calculations up. So 196, that is, for Star. Okay. 196 for Star. Then let's look at Messi 91. Messi has 4, 6, 8. So 96 bonus points on the Death Drakes. Plus he's in second. So he's looking at about 186 points. 186. Matrix, who's in third, has 3, 5 deaths, that's worth 60, and 4 snows, 64, so 124, plus third for 80, so he's at 204. So actually, it looks like the standings are it's a reverse of what we're seeing on the leaderboard. Dematrix is leading of Messi and Star in third, but Star adding another Storm Drake. So he's actually closing the gap right there. So that call was only good for the moment that it was called. Star really cranking now on those storms. Storm Soul, another snow. Dig a little bit deeper. Let's go back now to Lindsay, who's in fourth. Lindsay's got 3 Death Drakes, that's worth 36, and with his bonus skeezer windows, the equivalent of 5 snows, so 5, 50, 80, 116 bonus points right there for Lindsay, with a 70 points, so 186. So Lindsay actually right up there, he's at 186. Lindsay. Even though he's in fourth. Light Star in fifth, that's worth 60. And Light Star is looking at, got a lot to add up. Let's see, 12, 2, 3, great one. Wow, Lightstar's looking for 146 bonus points right now. So Lightstar's 146 plus his 60, he's at 206. Holy crap. Sorry, I don't know if that's professional commentating right there. But Lightstar all the way back in sixth place is right up there with the leaders. Let's take a look at Strong Soul in seventh. Oh, and just as we look at Strong Soul, he's nabbing another snow drake. So he's looking at 128 bonus points, Strong Soul, on top of being 128 on top of being in seventh, that's worth 40. So 168 for Strong Soul. Not bad at all. So really, the field is very tight. I'm not going to tally Taco right now. Let's just see Taco get some more globals and hoffs. So Yoda gets another Snow Drake worth 16. Actually, I will tally. He's at 65 bonus points right now in ninth. So he's okay back in the field. So he's got more to do. So Taco, Lunchbox, Blondie really have their work cut out. Let's take a look at Yoda. Yoda with 5 Snow Drakes. That's worth 80 on top of his fifth. Now moving ahead of Lightstar, so 60, so he's at 140, so he's, you know, trailing the leaders a bit, but there really is not a lot in it as we're moving into the 20-minute marker, there's really, it's a very, very, very tight field between 7th and 1st, maybe 50 points total. Very, very tight round going into round 2, unless we see some dramatic changes right now. One thing's for sure, Blondie needs to get going, and Lunchbox needs to get into it. So Genistar Mercury, Messi 91, The Matrix, Lindsay, Yoda, Lightstar, Strong Soul, Taco, Lunchbox, and Blondie. ...23 minutes remaining. So Star has focused entirely on the Storm Drakes thus far this event. Got off to a very slow start. Obviously that loot pool needed goosing. 8 Storm Drakes for him. Lightstar's scored 3 Storms, so 11 Storms I'm seeing. Drake Yoda, 14, 15, so we're looking at 15 Storm Drakes. Let's take a look, that versus the Death Drakes, 1, 4, 16 Death Drakes, so 15 Storms, 16 Death. Let's take a look how the Snow Drakes are. Wow. 18 Snow Drakes. That's interesting. So there's the Snow Drakes actually have been more yielding than the Death Drakes and the Great White and the Storm Drakes, and obviously they give out more points too. So that's quite interesting. Just 4 Great White Sharks thus far. So Death and Storm. So we are closing in now on the third and final skeezer window of this round. So time to wager to back your champions. Nice Storm Drake for Taco, just enough. That's a double hat trick for Taco now. So Taco not going to get left out of it because he's clocking up the points. There's Messi 91. It's been a while. Death Drake for Messi 91. Messi 91 now trading places with the Matrix, unless I misread that. But it looks like Messi just overtook the Matrix. Genistar Mercury, a commanding lead at this point for that extra 10 points that it gives. So Genistar Mercury, 10 points ahead of their Strong Soul again. So Jenna Star Mercury, Messi 91, The Matrix, Lindsay, Yoda, Strong Soul in 6, Light Star 7th, Tarko in 8th, Lunchbox in 9th, and Blondie in 10th. What on earth is Blondie hunting? Because I can't imagine that you can hunt anything for over an hour in this event and not score a single global. Unless you're hunting papoose. There's Tarko with a Kong. So, 18 minutes left of this round to go. I'd like to see some more of this. See Tarko really clocking him up. It would have been nice to see Lunchbox manage to keep pace with him, but Lunchbox struggling in this opening round. There's Blondie with a Death Drake, finally! 116 point Death Drake. I mean, that is just like uncanny that he's been hunting the Death Drakes and everybody else has been getting the globals. Wow. Alright, well, better late than never, Blondie. Had still 12 critical bonus points right there. And you still got the skeezer window. So let's take a look at the betting. We've got Doc Gray going for Strong Soul, Game Over PTP for Tarko, Doc Majer on Lightstar, Bubblicious on Jenna Star, Spark for Messi 91, Base 20 for Lindsay, K-Max for Strong Soul, and the Unicate for Blondie. Okay, so K-Max is actually on the Matrix. That's right, because Doc Gray's got Strong Soul. And we've got 15 minutes remaining of this round. Thank God Blondie scored. Let's see if the last 15 minutes can belong to Blondie and Lunchbox.
Whoa, wicked.
Great thing is you know, you get to change your strategy if you choose to in the second round, or maybe just the wind changes direction and you know, things go your way. But the good thing is this is the best of three. Not the best of three, it's the accumulation of all three rounds. So most importantly for Blondie and Lunchbox is to score in this next 15 minutes. Try to close the gap on the leaders as much as possible, so you don't leave yourself too much work to do. I mean, maybe that's if you're just sticking to plan. It's in the hands of the gods. But we are now within the 15-minute marker. Jenna Star Mercury leading the way ahead of Messi 91 and Matrix Lindsay in fourth. Yoda in fifth. Strong Soul 6. Lightstar 7. Tarko 8. Lunchbox 9. And Blondie in 10th.
Whoa, wicked.
So we need the streams, the live streams from Jenna Star Mercury, Messi 91, The Matrix, so we could cut to you guys. We need to see your action. There's The Matrix of the Snowdrake. Yeah, we're missing so many globals here. Don't you have Jenna Star streaming? I'm sure he's streaming. So Snowdrake for The Matrix. That's worth 2016.